of that segment of our lesson or our tutorial. And in this lesson, we are going to learn about introduction to Python programming. As you already know, we've installed an application called Python. And what actually is Python? All right, so Python is an interpreted object-oriented high-level programming language with dynamic semantics. Its high-level built-in data structures combined with dynamic typing and dynamic binding make it very attractive for rapid application development, as well as for use as a scripting language to connect existing components together. All right, so looking at our tutorial, we are supposed to learn that in our command prompt. And to do that, there are several ways in launching your command prompt. You can either go by pressing Start plus R, then you type in CMD, or wherever you are, whether you are in a folder or anything at all, you could just press Shift, hold down the Shift key, then right click on any empty space, then select Open Command Window here. Or you go to Start, then you type CMD, then you still have your command prompt. All right, so let's quickly move to the tutorial. All right, so I'm going to put this at the right side, then select the tutorial over here. Oh, all right, so the first thing to do is to type in Python in our command prompt. So I'll quickly do that. Python. Wow. All right, so you can see that it has bring another right tabs, a whole lot of things, and something blinking on our face. All right, so that actually means that Python is actually working on your machine. Assuming it's not working, it should give us an error, as you've seen earlier on during the installation. All right, so first of all, we are supposed to enter this particular. I'm going to zoom this now. All right, so we are to enter this in our console. So 2 plus 2. Wow. Oh, that is 4. Okay. Wow, 5. Wow, that's awesome. Then this our program is. Wow. 40 divided by 2. Wow, impressive. Why not try something like, all right, let's see, to the power 3. Oh, so 2 times times 3. Wow, this is so amazing. All right, so we just learned some few basic syntaxes of Python, and then we are moving on to strings. All right, so let's try something by typing our name over here in double quote. Then I'll type my name, Noah, and hit enter. Oh, it has printed Noah. All right, so let's try another one. So hi there, space, then plus, then let's say Noah. Wow. So all right, so what I just did over there with that plus symbol is called concatenation. In programming time, we call it concatenation. So we concatenated Noah with to the high there. All right, so the next thing to do is to try. Okay, over here. Hola. Okay. Hola times 3. Okay. Wow, it has repeated hola 3 times. That's awesome. All right, so the other way, another thing to do now is to type this in double quote, then running down the hill. Hit enter. Wow. Okay, so we can try another one. This time I will be using the single quote. Then inside this, we use the backslash. All right, hit enter. Okay, nice. All right, so nice and excellent. All right, so now we are going to see your name in, they say we are going to see our names in capital letters. Well, so we are going to use a method. All right, so I'll type my name. Noah, hello. Then you have to dot appa. Wow. It has actually changed all the characters to uppercase. It's impressive. Alright, so the next thing to do is to check, use a function called len. So let's see how it works. So we type len, then into bracket, double quote, then we type Noah. Wow. So the number of characters or the length of that word is 4. Amazing. Alright, so in summary, we've learned about the prompt whereby we input the commands or the code. Then we also move to learn about the numbers, strings, operators like plus and times, and also the functions such as the dot upper and dot len. Alright, so we are moving on to errors. So as a programmer, you should expect errors along the line whenever you are developing your or you are working on your programming course, or you are working on your course. You should expect some errors or some few errors along the line. Alright, so let's quickly try our first error over here by typing this function len, and then you pass a number inside, which is 384023. Then we close it and we hit enter. Alright, so you realize that we have some error over here because the len is not is okay. So the len, the type that we are putting inside len is what an integer, of which len, the function is to work on a string. Okay, so now what you're going to do in order to get the length of that particular character is to write this by typing this, then to bracket string, then another this thing, then we type the 304023, close this and close it again to get the, wow, so it has now given us the length of that particular characters. I said that we can also go by this method by typing len, then put it inside double quote, then we type 304023, then we close this, and yeah, it will still give us 6, as you can see. So this works on strings and not on integer, unless we pass the string, the integer to string. Alright, so now we are moving on to variable. And what variable we've all learned, or you've learned about variable, like e plus 2 equal to 4. And e is what? 2. Then what you have to do is to substitute that, right? Alright, so it's something of that sort. Alright, so what we are doing is we are writing name and equal to then Ola or Noah. Alright, Noah. Alright, so what actually we are doing is we are storing Noah in name. So the equal to sign we are seeing over there is not the equal to sign as we know earlier on, that 1 plus 1 equal to 2, no. Or A equal to 2, no. What we are doing is we are storing the word Noah in name, the variable name. So we hit enter now, and anytime we type name, it should print what, Noah, as you can see. All right so let's give it another try again. So we type name equal to then hello, and we hit enter. That's all. Now we type name, you see it has printed hello now. Alright, so now we can even check the length of that particular string. So name, wow, 6. All right, so let's try basic this thing, arithmetics. All right, so A equal to 4, B equal to 6, B equal to 6. So we do A times B. Wow, 24. Really? Programming is fun. All right, so let's then move to another one, which is city. Then we type in Tokyo. Tokyo. Then we hit enter. Then when you write this. All right, so this has not been defined, or we've not declared CTIY. The initial one that we've declared is what? CT. So you must be mindful of your your characters, how you write them, no like missing them or whatever. Like you have to define that particular variable. If it's not defined, it will not bring you the result, expected results that you are expecting. All right, so now let's work on the print function now. So we type name equal to Maria. Maria, then we say print. Okay, so we write name, it's print, so it's Maria now. Then we say print, then to bracket, sorry, print this, then name. Wow, Maria now. All right, so that is just by the way. All right, so another thing is to learn about list. You know, when you're going to buy something, goods or anything of that sort, you have to prepare your list. So in other words, we call it an array. So what we are going to do now is to type this square brace and hit enter. Nothing pops out. So now we create a variable log tree and assign it to the list that's inside the square brace, which is 3, 42, 12, 19, 30, and then 59. And we hit enter. So let's check the length. Then load tree. Oh, so you see, so when you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfect. All right, so now let's learn another function, which is sort. So what it's going to do is going to arrange that for us. So we say load tree dot sort. Then we say print into brackets load tree. Wow. So comparing the top one, initially it was 3, 4, 2 and up to this, it's not well arranged, but now you can see we have 3, 12, 19, well, like ascending order. All right, so that is just by the way. All right, so let's learn about the reverse. Initially, we've sorted the list. Now we want to reverse it now. All right, so we type load tree dot reverse. Reverse. We'll be using that function. Hit enter. Then we say print into bracket load tree. Hit enter. All right, so it has reversed now, and from descending to ascending. All right, so that is it. So the next thing is to append 199 to the list. So it's something like adding another item to the list. So we say load tree. So we'll be using the append function. Append then we add 199 to it. Alright, so when you say print lottery, then realize that we've added another item to the list. Alright, so now we are going to learn about the indices. So looking at the items over here, starting from here in array, start from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's why I can. So we have 6 items over there. Over here right now, we have 7. Okay, but initially, like, it starts counting from 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so when we type in print into bracket lottery, and you type 0 over here and hit enter, it's giving us this, then 2, then it will give us 30, then we select 1 to give us that. Perfect. Okay, so we can also use another function as that pop, POP. So we say lottery.pop, and say 0. So it pops out 59 for us. Alright, so let's type print into brackets lottery. Oh, so now we've removed the 59 from the list. So we can try it again by bringing this. Then we say this item, so it is 3. Then we print lottery again. We realize 3 is missing from the list. Wow, it works like a charm. Alright, so you're coming to learn about dictionaries. A dictionary is similar to a list, but you access values by looking up a key instead of a numeric index. A key can be a string or number. The syntax to define an empty dictionary is this command line. This. Alright, so let's quickly move to this synthesis of the dictionary. Alright, so we declare a variable called participant and then assign it to this single quote name, then if this, then another one, write hola, then comma, then another one, country, then this, then we write this Poland, this favorite underscore numbers, then this. Put the list in the sky brace, 7, 42, and then 92. Then we close the dictionary now. Then we hit enter. Alright, so now let's print participant from our dictionary. Participant. And this name. Close this. Hit enter. Wow, hola. Alright, so as you already, you can see over here, we have hola assigned to name. Okay. Then we can when we input H here, you should expect an error because it's not included in our dictionary. Okay. Then So we can do this and come to. Okay, so we have to add another this into the favorite language. So participants, favorite, underscore. So come on. Language equal to Python. All right, so hit enter. Then you say len and participant. All right, so 4. All right, so that is it. We can also remove that from the list by using participant dot pop. Hit enter. Okay, so we. Okay, I selected languages instead of numbers. Favorite numbers. Alright, so we realize that we have this. And then we type participant. Alright, so we have name, hola, country, and the Python. Okay, I should have used the other one earlier on, sorry. Alright, so let's add country to the list now. So, participant. Country equal to Germany. Alright, so participant. Alright, so in summary, we've learned about the errors, variable, leaks, and dictionary. Alright, so now let's compare things. Alright, so is 5 greater than 2? True. Alright, so is 3 less than 1? That should be false. Yes, that's correct. Okay, so let's try and give it another one. This one, let's make it more complicated. 5 greater than 2 times 2. Wow, the answer is what? True. Alright, so another thing is 1 equal to, equal to 1. And the answer is true. It's 1 equal to 1. Alright, so in programming, double equal to means equal to. Alright, so 5 factorial equal to, not equal to 2. True. Alright, so let's make it more complicated. So let me put this in up. Alright, so 6. This equal to 12. Oh, okay. 3, 2, 4. Alright, so what we just learned is that S is greater than Y, and S is greater than, or is less than Y, or S is less than or equal to Y. S is greater than or equal to Y. Alright, so those are some of the things that we just learned. And alright, so let's give it another try. So we see this one will be bringing the and or to the our code. So C is greater than 2 and 2 greater than 3. The statement is true. Let me give it another try. Greater than is 3 greater than 2 and 2 less than 1. That is false. All right, so we will not do all that. Okay, so let's give it another try, another one which will actually bring us an error. 1 is less than this string Django. Error. So you realize that Django is a string, not an integer. So we can know whether one is greater than Django or not. All right, so Boolean is a true or false statement. So yeah, the next this thing is to learn about the Boolean. The Boolean. All right, so E equal to true. A. Okay, so A equal to two greater than 5. Then A is false. Alright, so you can practice more of the Boolean and then you can know how those particular commands works. Alright, so now we are going to exit this, the Python programming. Then we are back to our command prompt. So if I should type 2 plus 2 over here right now, error. So unless you type in Python before, it will be able to do any coding or any commands or issue any commands in terms of the Boolean, the and, the less than or equal to sign or the equal to sign. All right. Okay, so the next thing to do now is to launch our code editor. You realize during the installation we install Sublime Text 3, so I'll double click on that and open it. Right, put it to this place, the right side. All right, so after you finish launching your text or code editor, I'm going to paste this code inside. So you copy. Either write or you copy this line of code and paste over here. All right, so the next thing to do is to save it to this particular file name onto your desktop. So we come here, then we save, then locate desktop, then we paste it over there, then we hit save. Okay. Alright, so okay, so it's now Python underscore intro dot py. Then let's follow the this thing now. Alright, so we are to navigate to our desktop, then we launch that particular application. Alright, so we You know, when I started the video, I said there are several ways in launching the command prompt. So we press shift and this to make things very easier for us. Then we select that. So right now we are on the desktop, and what we need to type is to write the Python underscore intro dot py. Sorry, you have to type the Python first. Python and Python underscore. Yep. So it has printed, "Hello, Django girls." What's written over here? Print, "Hello, Django girls." That's awesome. All right, so you just ran your first Python program that was saved to a file. And then now, so we are going to replace the file inside this thing with this. I'll not type this time around. I'll then save it. Then come back to this and type. Okay. All right. So I'll save this now. Then, let's make this correction now. Open this file on desktop. Then I'll close this. No. Okay. So I'll save this now. Then I'll launch the command prompt. Okay, to this side. Then Python. Then Python underscore intro dot py. Alright, so we have an error over here on line 2, and let's quickly check that out. So if 3 is greater than 2, then there's nothing there for us. So we have an error, so we have to include this line to the statement. So come here, hit enter, then you save it. Then when you come here back to the console and we hit, it works great. So looking at the if statement, you say if 3 is greater than 2, then if you print, it works. But then initially we didn't give any statement, so it doesn't know what to do. It's just stuck over there. All right, so that is it. So now we are going to do another one. So we copy the entire test over here, come back to the Python intro here, then we paste it. And if I should save this, I'm not sure it works. So you have to make sure your indents are correct, aligned to this particular one over here. If it's not like that, it'll give you an error. All right, so let's save this and come back to the console and hit enter. 5 is indeed greater than 2. Awesome. All right, so let's come down. Then let's try another one. You copy this. Paste this. Don't forget the indent is very, 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 very important. Together with this, let's come back to this. Please let me copy. Okay, so the print indent. And we save it. Then so name equal to Sonja, and if name equal to Ola, print "Hey Ola," else name equal to Sonja, print "Hey Sonja." Okay, so we run this again. All right, so we realize that the name is Sonja now, so it has printed "Hey Sonja." All right, so then let's try another. Let's write Ola over here this time around. Let's save it. Come back to this place, then hit enter. "Hello, Ola." So the name equal to Ola, so you should print what? "Hey, Ola." Alright, so that is it. Let's come down. Alright, so let's use the else if statement now. So let's quickly copy this to our test editor. And make sure we work on the indent of the print. All right, now let's save. Save. Then we come back to the console and hit enter. Perfect, I can hear all the details. All right, so let's quickly read the code. Okay. Perfect, I can hear all the details. So it works. Okay. All right, so the next thing is to introduce comment in our code. So comment really gives us what actually that line is going to do. So to give a comment, you can either use backslash, that is depending on the language that you're using. So Python, you use the hash sign, then write change the volume if it's too loud or too quiet. All right, so then we copy this, all of this, then we clear the other one. Save, then come back here. Okay. So that's what I'm telling you about the indent. Let's quickly see. Volume is not defined. All right, so it's saying volume is not defined. So let's undo everything in this so that we have this over here for now. Then we can actually paste that code here now. Try to work. Okay, we have an indentation error. Okay, so I'll save this. Then doesn't do anything. Let me comment this. Yeah, let's save. So the same volume is not defined.